Hi guys, it's Anna, and today I'm in Gimkit, which is a quiz game website that we have a subscription to. And I want to show you a really quick way to put together a kit, which is what they call the quiz game, pulling in questions that others have created. So, going through our units of study survey that Heidi did, one of the topics Miss Meyer requested was ballet. So I just want to show you, for instance, if I searched for ballet and pulled up some quiz games or kits that others had made, this is an example. This one has some good questions in it, but if I go up to the top, the first question is, my mind is blank. I don't know what else to put. I also noticed right here, tendu is spelled wrong. So I might want to pick and choose some questions from this kit, but not use the whole kit. I mean, there are a whole bunch of others here, some of which have good questions and some, a mix of good and not great. There was another one where it asks, what's the teacher's dream car? Which is maybe a question I want to leave out if I'm going to use the kit. So what I want to show you, I'm going to click on Gimkit to go back to my front page. How to make a kit where you pull in selected questions from other people's kits, without reusing their whole kit, which may not have things that you like. This is a really quick way to build a quick kit. So in my main screen, I'm going to click on New Kit here, and I'm going to give it a name. Select a language, and then you can choose. A topic, a subject, and I'll do next. It will suggest for you, based on the name that you picked, some possible images that you might use as the image for your kit. So we'll just pick one. And then it's showing me over here the different choices for adding questions. Now, if you just want to make up your own questions, you can click on Add Question. And there's some other ways to do, but today I'm going to look at Add from Question Bank and search again for ballet. It's going to bring up all those same kits I was looking at before, but now I can go in and pick and choose which questions I want to use. So for instance, I noticed this one has some different interesting questions, but all the words are spelled wrong. This is not how you spell wrong, Chate. That's not how you spell pirouette. So, I'm looking at these critically to see which might be good question options. So as I go through these, and notice I'm not clicking on them, I'm just putting my mouse over to switch to the next one. So what you can do is go through and just pick the questions that you want to use, and I'll click the little plus sign to add it to my kit. There was one that I saw that had lots of different images in the questions of different types of movements. Here we go. That might be a good option. Course, I am not a dancer, so some of these could be incorrect, but you'll know your subject and be able to determine which ones to use. So as you go through, you can just look at each different one and pick out the questions that you like. When you get done, I'm going to click back here to return back to my kit that I'm making. I can continue to add additional questions here or here if I want to make up some of my own questions. But when I get done, I can just do finish kit, and then I've got a finished kit with a bunch of different questions that I pulled in from different places. So I just think that's a quick way, especially when you search, if you don't find a kit that you like as is, or you like parts of each one, it's a quick way to pull together a kit to use right away with your students. So hope this was helpful to you guys. Thanks.